Hello, this is Svetlana Shipitsina, and this tutorial is about testing creating a message functionality with AngularJS. I'm using Vim and Visual Studio Remap shortcuts during my work. All of them you can find at my Google Plus profile. In our application, in order to create a testing for our create message functionality, first of all, in folder scripts, in app controllers, I created additional controller, create message controller. And in tests controllers, I added TypeScript document for creating our creating message controller, for testing, sorry, our creating message controller. And when we open our spec runner, you can see that for create message controller, I added script of our controller and test for it, and also I added message JavaScript. And when I open TypeScript document, you can see that I created a constructor for our message. I can close it for now. And I can close spec runner, and in create message view with Ctrl L, I can find location. In messages templates, I added view form for our create message functionality. And now it's just form without any using any coding directives. And first of all, in our test, I need to describe what I'm going to test here. And it's first of all name of our controller, and then anonymous function. And after that, I need to create a method that will run before running our tests. And it's called before each, and I have a template for it. A before each, it's created very fast. And I'm creating injection here with parameters. Root scope, it's from our Angular mock and controller, and I also need HTTP backend in order to emulate collaboration with HTTP. Then I need HTTP, just HTTP parameter, and location in order to have possibility to change location after creating our message. And then we declared all our variables and set it inside before each. And we also created create message controller. We added like a variable too, and with name of our controller for creating message. And after that, location like this, type on, and after that, according to rules, we need to add our tests. We need to add description. What we are going to test. And I also have a template for it. It's empty. And I created automatically four tests. They are empty for now. And after that, I need I will use expect element with scope and then new message, and then to be defined, and it's for test that we give a description that it should define new message object, and we use expect scope new message to be defined, and after that we can run our application from index. And we can't run behavior-driven development test from our Visual Studio application. We need to use Jasmine run. And for now, all our four tests failed, and we can stop application in our messages controller. First of all, we need to add a controller action result for creating a message, and I also use a template, a create message action. It created automatically, and I also can use a template for Plunker website. And it's in message controller. I have action create, action result, and I also can copy and insert it from here. And I save it. And in our action result, I bounded properties from our model receiver subject and body, and also added object message from our model, and I set sender as logged user name, since all we need to get a logged user name in order to send message from for example for user 1 for user for a logged user 1, and after that we set date time. We will use it in future, and we create variable message added to database, and here we use our repository message from repo container and add object message, and if our message created successfully, then we use JSON. It's filter in module ng. It's JSON object. And in order to allow get, we need to use syntax JSON request behavior allow get. And if something went wrong, we return HTTP status code result 500. It means that we got a mistake. And if everything fine, usually we get in browser result 200. We have our controller action result create ready for us, and after that in our create message controller in TypeScript we need to add production code, and I also have a template for fast inserting. It's a create controller, and everything should work after that. And what I did here, I created a variable with name of our controller. It's our object with scope, HTTP and location. And I create an object new message, and I also set error alert for sending a message. And after our code in controller TypeScript created, we can add to our form ng module, and it will be faster if I use form from Plunker. I can copy just what I have insert and insert for form with directives quickly. And here we have a set ng module to our object created in controller new message. Sorry, it's not here. Here, new message, a receiver, subject, body, and with ng click, we send our message on click. And now I need to comment these tests, because they will be shown as passed by mistake. And in index, I click F5. I just can reload it here. And our test is passed. Create message controller, we can see it here, should define new message object, and everything looks great. And that's it for today, and in the next tutorial I will show you how to create another test for creating message functionality. Thank you, bye bye.